The bedrock of the White Mountains is mostly composed of igneous and metamorphic rocks, with numerous intrusions and contact zones between different rock types aged from the Silurian, that ended about 420 million years ago, to the Devonian, that ended around 360 million years ago. The area underwent compressional forces when the Lapidus Sea, an early proto-Atlantic ocean, started to close and force one part of the crust to subduct under the other. These forces pushed up the bedrock as well as create new volcanic activity. The remnants today are not indicative of the scale of these mountains when they were young. At one point, these too would have been comparable to what we see in the Rockies or the Alps. Erosion has rubbed away at these mountains to what we see today, which are deep-formed granites and volcanic rocks, all sprinkled with glacial deposits from our last ice age. The area is so geologically diverse that many rock hounds visit the area to discover the various mineral deposits. Gold panning is also a common activity in the rivers throughout the area. Both activities require permits first. I'm visiting the Hancock Campground, one of the only two open in the White Mountain National Forest during the winter. I was fortunate to be near a beautiful river. I hope you enjoy.